I'm Scott Walker, and this is Walks on the Wild Side. In today's video, we're going to be taking an alternative approach to summer woodland photography. Welcome back to Walks on the Wild Side, the channel where I help you capture the beauty of nature through your camera lens. So, my woodland photography is normally from a landscape point of view, and I take pictures like these. During the autumn, winter and spring, that's great, but during the summer, you don't tend to get photos like this because the woodland is just so green, and so I often take the summer months off from woodland. But I've been thinking about different ways which I can approach the woodlands to get some photos that have an interesting perspective. And in today's video, we're going to be focusing on high contrasts and small details immediately after sunrise. So let's go. So firstly, it's going to help to be in some really dense woodlands. And as you can see behind me, the trees are all crammed in quite tightly together. And also, as the sun is rising, you can start to see some of the patches of light just hitting some of the trees. And you want to look for those high areas of contrast where there's light illuminating a subject, maybe a leaf or a twig with a cobweb hanging from it or something like that. And expose for the bright parts so that the background falls away into darkness. The second thing I'd recommend is to bring some insect repellent, because at this time of the morning there's lots of things buzzing around that are looking to have their breakfast and they want to dine on my blood. So it's important to note that these moments are fleeting. The light, or the good light, can last for just a few seconds before it disappears as the sun rises in the sky. And so I haven't really got time to talk you through each shot. You've just got to shoot on instinct. So you haven't got time to be thinking, what about this composition? What if I tried that angle? Let me change the aperture. Go for what you think by your gut. And then if you've still got time and you've still got the light, you can change your settings or your composition and get a second shot. But as a result of this, I'm not able to talk you through each photo that I'm taking. The other thing that I would say is that this footage you're watching of me probably looks a lot lighter than it was in reality. And because the woodland is so dark at this time of the morning, I've had to raise the ISO quite a lot so that you can actually see me in the shot and I'm not just a silhouette. Shoot into the light for lens flare, sun rays, and sunbursts. And be prepared to shoot past golden hour as the sun rises in the sky for some beautiful bokeh. Don't forget your insects, spiders, and other small critters. Thank you. Ivy can make a really interesting subject, particularly if you can find some dead ivy. The ivy doesn't live as long as trees, so it dies off and it will leave behind orange leaves that give that autumnal feel. And if the leaves have all dropped away, the ivy vines can make really interesting subjects too. And don't forget to try different kinds of close-ups of tree barks, which can be really interesting. Well, I got about an hour and a half of interesting light there, but now the sun is too high in the sky to take the kind of shots that I was taking. Has it satisfied my need to take woodland photos in the summer? Yeah, I think it has. I've really enjoyed it, and I'd need to get out on lots more days to accumulate a lot more shots. But this as a starting point has been really good. And I've got a few other ideas for other ways of doing alternative woodland summer photography. So if that interests you, please click the subscribe button. And if you enjoyed today's video, please hit the like button. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.